Hi, it's Tom again, and I'm in the Centennial Garden at the University of Wisconsin-Madison. And I want to use some plants that they have here of examples of floral structure. And for instance, we're going to start with the Lophospermum here. One of the key features that I want you to see about flowers, or conceptually understand about flowers, is that the flowers are put together on four nodes of a compressed stem. So we've talked a lot about nodes and internodes, but if you can imagine this being compressed, a stem being compressed, so it's just four very, very tight nodes and internodes, that's what flowers are built on. And each of these nodes have a particular structure attached to them. So for instance, well, let's take a good example of a flower down here, although it's a little bit beat from age, but these structures attached to the lowermost of the four nodes are called the calyx collectively. Individually, they're each called sepals, but this node I often call the calyx node because we have a calyx attached to it. The next node up I call the corolla node because the corolla is attached to it. What's the corolla? Well, it's made up of petals. Now, in this case, this Lophos has fused petals. What do I mean by fused? Well, instead of the petals being individual, one, two, three, four, five individual petals, they're fused into a trumpet shape. They're all connected together at the bottom. But this is still called collectively the corolla, and it's made up of petals. So you have calyx with the sepals and corolla with the petals. I've taken away the corolla of this particular flower, and so we can see inside now at the parts that are attached to the innermost whorls. What we see here are stamens with the white anther head. So a stamen is made up of an anther and a filament, and collectively those are called the androecium. It's the male part of the flower. Well, this might be hard to see, but if you look under my thumb, I've bent back the androecium, the stamens, the anther and filament. And here, hopefully as a backdrop against the red portion of a petal that I left, is the carpel, which makes up the gynoecium. Oops, hold on. There we go. Hard to see, but it's the carpel, and this is the female part, and it's made up of a stigma at the very tip, which is where the pollen lands, and a style, which is a long tube that comes down to the base, where we have the ovary pinched in between my fingers. So just as a review then, remember that a flower is built on four compressed nodes. We have the calyx node that has the sepals, which is right under my finger, right over my finger. Then we have, in this case, five petals that are fused together that make up the corolla. Inside, you can perhaps see some of the white tips, which are the anthers making up the stamen. Remember, the stamen's made up of anther and filament, and collectively the stamens are called the androecium. And then right between them is a real skinny carpel, which is made up of the stigma that lies right up by the anthers and is where the pollen is attaches. A long style, which is the tube that leads all the way down inside the trumpet shape there to the base where we have the ovary.